Chapter 2, Numerical Comparisons. In studying real-world issues, we frequently look at changes that take place in something of interest to us. In this chapter, you will learn how to quantify such changes. We start with a review of percentages. The word per translates as for each or for every. The word cent signifies 100. So percent means for each 100 or for every 100. If we say 3% or we write the symbol 3%, we're saying 3 for every 100. In a real-world setting, we might be saying that 3 people out of every 100 are infected with a virus, or that 3 liters of water out of every 100 liters of water are contaminated. Recall that percents can be represented either by fractions or by decimals. In the case of 3%, these representations are 3 out of 100, or 3/100. And then if we write this fraction as a decimal, it would be 0.03. Let's go ahead and complete the following table. 91%, that translates as 91 out of 100, or written as a fraction, 91/100. 91/100, written as a decimal, is 0.91. 6% means 6 out of 100, or 6/100. Written as a decimal, it's 0.06. Now let's work backwards. In the next line, we have 24/100 as a fraction. That's 24/100. This translates into 24 out of 100, which, written as a percentage, is 24%. One more. 0.75, that's 75/100, written as a fraction. It's 75/100. This signifies 75 out of 100, which we would write as 75%. It's worth noting here that if I start with percentages and I want to calculate their decimal representations, I simply do this by taking my percentages and moving the decimal point 2 places to the left. If you look at 91%, the decimal point is located behind the 1, just to the right. The decimal representation of 91% has the decimal point located 2 places to the left. If we started with the decimal representation and we wanted to calculate the percentage, notice that we simply take our decimal representations and move the decimal point 2 places to the right to obtain the percentages. Suppose that you are asked to determine 60% of 700. What does this mean? Well, 60%, that's 60 out of 100, is equivalent to the fraction 60/100, or when simplified, 3/5, which is equivalent to the decimal 0.6. So 60% of 700 is equivalent to saying 3/5 of 700. If you were going to calculate 3/5 of 700, you would do that by multiplying 3/5 by 700. Let's look at this in the line below. 60% of 700 is equal to 3/5 of 700. To do this multiplication, we express 700 as the fraction 700/1. We go ahead and multiply the two fractions, and the result is 420. Alternatively, we could calculate 60% of 700 by, instead of working with the fraction 3/5, we could replace it with its decimal. So instead of multiplying by 3/5, we're multiplying by 0.6. Regardless, The answer is 420. In general, suppose that p percent of some number x is equal to y. In other words, p percent of x equals y. And let's just assume that this is a capital P for the percentage. If we use little p, lowercase p, to represent the decimal representation of the percentage, we calculate, we can rewrite this equation as little p times x is equal to y. So little p times the amount you're calculating the percentage of is equal to the amount remaining. Let's go ahead and use this equation to complete the following examples. We'll work these together. Example 2.1. Determine 15% of 50. So 15% of 50. 15% can be written as a decimal, as 0.15. To calculate 15% of 50, we multiply the 0.15 by 50. The result, when we do this on our calculator, is 7.5. So 7.5 is 15% of 50. Let's look at example 2.2. 10 is what percent of 25? This problem is a little different. In this problem, we're trying to determine the percentage. We don't know what p equals. But we can still set up an equation because we're told all of the necessary information. We are told that p percent of 25 must equal 10. So therefore, if I write p percent in its decimal form, that's little p, and I multiply it by 25, I know I should get 10. If p times 25 is equal to 10, that must mean that p is equal to 10 divided by 25. If I do this division on my calculator, I get the decimal 0.4, which translates into 40%. So 40% of 25 is equal to 10. Let's look at example 2.3. 6 is 20% of what number? Now, in this case, there's a different component that we are looking for. We are told that 20% of some number x that we don't know is equal to 6, and we need to determine x. Let's rewrite this as an equation. 20% as a decimal is 0.2, or 0.20 if you like. We multiply that by our unknown number, and the result has to be 6. If x times 0.2 is equal to 6, I can calculate x by taking 6 and dividing it by 0.2. If I work this out on a calculator, I arrive at 30. So 20% of 30 is 6. Now, that should make some sense. 20% is 20 out of 100. 20 out of 100, if you reduce that to lowest terms, it's the same as 1/5. If you took 1/5 of 30, what would you get? If you think about that for a little bit, 1/5 of 30 would be 30 divided by 5, which is 6. And so we're arriving at the result that we were supposed to get. Let's look at example 2.4. Here we have an application. Suppose the population of a city a few years ago was 22,000, and now it is reduced to 14,500. What percentage of the original population still remains, and what percentage was lost? Okay, in this problem, we're trying to determine some percentages. So let's let P percent represent the percent that is remaining, just to be clear. Now, we are told that 14,500 people are still residing in the city. So if we took P percent, in other words, the percentage remaining, if we took P percent of 22,000, we should get how many people are still there, which is 14,500. Let's write this as an equation. P percent, written as a decimal, that's the little p. We take little p times the 22,000, and we set that equal to the 14,500. To determine p, I take the 14,500 and divide by the 22,000. If I work this out on a calculator and I get a decimal, and if I round the decimal to two places, I get 0.66. This is approximate. Again, rounded to two decimal places. Now, if I translate this into a percentage by moving the decimal point two places to the right, I arrive at 66%. Now remember, the 66% refers to the percentage remaining. So this city still has 66% of its original population. So the percentage that was lost would be found by taking 100% and subtracting off the 66%, which leaves us with 34%. Let's go ahead and look at example 2.5. Suppose the population of a city a few years ago was 22,000 and that it has grown by 5%. By how many people has the city grown? And what's the size of the population now? There's two questions we want to explore in this example. Let's start by looking at the growth. How many more people are in the city now? We're told that it's grown by 5%. 5% of what? It's understood to be 5% of what the population was a few years ago. So 5% of 22,000. 5% of 22,000 is calculated by multiplying 0.05 times 22,000. And if we work this out on our calculators, we arrive at 1,100 new people in the city. This is the growth. The second part of this example asks, what is the size of the population now, or the current size? So let's figure that out. To calculate the current size, I take how many people there were a few years ago and add how many new people there are, in the city. That gives me the population currently. If I add, I get 23,100.